I am the police. We are here to do an investigation. Now, first and foremost, you've probably not heard of Tech Amelia, aka Cyber Amelia. Luckily, she's left us a description of who she is. 19 and lesbian, autistic, air dryer, cybersecurity, welcome. So now you guys know who she is. No, you don't, okay. Effectively, she got some popularity, and the way I found out about her TikTok account was she worked at Tesco. Okay, that doesn't make any sense either. To be fair, I'm here trying to explain it, and it makes no fucking sense. Did somebody break your heart? There we go. So you're just here getting your meal deal, which is £3.90 now. Thanks, inflation. Yeah, you're here ordering your meal deal, and you know, you just have dancing along at work. Yeah. So that's where she got famous from, and she also has an obsession with like the she's obsessed with tech, but more specifically in terms of Tesco, she's obsessed with like the self checkout systems. Yeah, so her special interest is NCR fast lanes. Tesco, I'm not being funny, but how the fuck did she get a job at your place of work? Like, come on, guys. She's mental. Now, after working at Tesco for a bit, I don't know how long she worked there. I think it was like a year or something. She eventually quit. I think she quit because she had some issues with like the disciplinary process. Like, I think she was off because of medical illness. And then, you know, Tesco were livid at her and they were trying to like open an investigation and shit. And she got really upset by that. And then what happened after that is she stopped working at Tesco. Then she created this game where you could work at Tesco on Roblox, and it's called Little Blocks Co. Convenience Store. And here's where it gets interesting. Brought to you by me and my great giraffe. I remember seeing this. Brought to you by my great giraffe. What the fuck does that even mean? This girl, this is her girlfriend. This girl, I don't know how old she is, but she's young as fuck. So Amelia is 19. I think you guys saw that in the bio that I read. So Amelia is 19. This is from 2020, so this was 2 years ago. She legit looks 11 in this video. Like, she's 11 years old in that video. And if she's 11 years old in 2020, she's what, 13, 14? I also want to just mention that Amelia is trans, and obviously there's nothing wrong with that. But at the end of the day, she's, how do I say it? Like, obviously, she's a woman, but she's like a man. Oh no, I'm in big trouble for this one. I don't know how to say it. Like, she's a woman, I respect that, but she is like physically a man. Like, she's tall as shit because she was born a man. So like for me, when it comes to like grooming, which is what I'm gonna be talking about later in the video, I think it's worse because she's so, like, because she's born a man. It's, I know it sounds terrible, but it's terrible grooming. So, oh no. She even bought, this is ridiculous. She even bought the team support headset that they use at Tesco just for personal use. Like, look at this.
There we go. So I've just had a call with it. It's super clear and the noise cancellation is
amazing. It literally sounds like shit. Sounds like you're talking from a bloody, the moon. It's like you're on the moon and you're talking through the intercom.
So as you can see, the headset there is appearing as an audio type.
And with a range that's 11 times that of Bluetooth, it works well even outside.
What is in her house? Why does she have a smart board? Meeting with Amelia, Chief Security Office. Bro, you're at home. What do you mean security office? This is your residence. What? What is this? What is this as well? What do you use that for? When I initially saw, you know, this girl being featured on her TikTok account, it wasn't a big deal because I thought they were just friends. You know, this TikTok, happy birthday, Abby. You're my absolute best friend in the world. Nothing wrong with that. They're friends, and you know, there's nothing so bad with that. But this is where it gets weird. Okay, so firstly is, how old is Abby? You may be wondering. Her name's Abby, yeah. Fuck. I don't know how old she is, but she doesn't look older than 12 in these videos. Like 12, 13, and these were 2 years ago. So she's either like 14 or 15, okay? So, you know, there's nothing wrong with that TikTok wishing happy birthday and shit. But then what happened is they met up. And obviously meeting up, they're friends. That's all right. Let's see the videos of them meeting up. So we got their matching outfits. It's a shame their age doesn't match. She's 19. So like she's 14, she's 19. That's a big age difference. Is this your first time meeting and how did you meet? We've known each other for years online, but the first time in person. So, you know that video where I've shown you, well, not that video, but like one of these videos I've shown you, like this one. This is from 2 years ago. Look how fucking young she looks. And at this time, 2 years ago, you know, Draft's like, what, 12, 11? And Amelia's like 18, 17. What the fuck are you doing talking to a 12-year-old kid, a 13-year-old kid, when you're 17, 18, that's ridiculous. I mean, if you're friends, fine, that you can be friends with each other, but that's when it becomes a real grey area, especially if it grows into something, because that is grooming. That is grooming through and through. It is when you approach a child and you build trust, you build that good relationship with them, you wait for them to grow older. I mean, she didn't wait long enough because she's still underage, but that's what grooming is. And you'll see where it gets a bit weird, or weirder. And the reason why I'm doing this video is because I think it's really important to understand that in the LGBT community, which both these people are in, grooming, sexual assault, shit like that, is a bigger issue than in the non-LGBT community because it goes so under the radar. It's crazy. What is this video? What are they laughing about? Probably the age of consent. So they did a compilation video of the first day meeting. Me and my great giraffe. Why are you saying my great giraffe? We've been internet besties for over a year. So a year ago, Amelia was 18 and a man. I really want to make the point clear, there's nothing wrong with being trans. So here they are on their date night. Date day, going bowling.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. That's like. Oh my god, yeah, that's so good to see that. Bowl the photo.
And what I find interesting about it, just want to quickly mention this. Like, we're so similar and we both have the exact same disabilities. Lesbians of TikTok. This is where it gets a bit weird. Lesbian queen. You're hanging out with a kid. This girl's 14, you're 19 years old. You know, you've talked to her for over a year, 13, 14, and you're here saying that you're lesbians, hashtag lesbians of TikTok, hashtag lesbians, hashtag twinning. Weird.
Oh my god, that's so good. Yeah.
Oh my god, that's so good. Bro, you have the barriers up. You can't miss.
So we're at the exact same score because we're like so identical. Oh my god, is it?
We're like so identical. That's so weird to say about someone that's like a child. Because like the whole point of grooming is you're making them feel like they can trust you and saying shit like, oh, we're so similar. We're the same. We're twinning. Like, it's just bad. It's bad connotations.
Ooh,
And I can't help but feel like this is quite sexualized because, like, the way she's bowling and she's throwing it, it's like, yeah, she's really putting her body into it. Like, am I reaching here? Am I reaching it? But it just seems weird. It just seems weird.
Yeah, zonal. It's like Tesco Cafe vibe. But these screens never worked in Tesco Cafe. No, I don't know why.
No one cares! Why the fuck are you wearing headphones? What are you doing a goddamn reaction video? Like, well, why are you wearing headphones while you're with someone in a photo booth? Like, I get, actually, I'm being rude. I get that some people are sensitive to, like, audio and shit. Like, you could have taken them off for the photos. Come on. Come on, Amelia. What the fuck is this TikTok? What is this TikTok? I'm all the way up. You're just lifting a fucking unit of a woman. We ain't never leave, never leave. Counting up this money, we ain't never sleep, never sleep. You got V12, I got 12 V's. Got bottles, got I'm all the way. Shorty, up. What you want, I got what you need. Shorty, what you want, I got what you need. Shorty, what you want, I got what you need. It's obviously not just friends.
Let's go, lesbians, let's go!
So this TikTok, here we go.
Here we go, lesbians, come on! Oh my god, lesbians!
So, someone's wrote the sound. Tesco have decided to leave a comment. We're both lesbians. How can you say you're both lesbians? She's literally a child. She's literally 14 years old. It's just weird because she's answering on behalf of her as well. It's like, we're both lesbians. And you're doing a TikTok, like, you're putting pressure on her. Like, that's the thing that frustrates me. Like, the whole point of grooming is that you're putting pressure on someone who doesn't have much power because they're young to feel a certain way. And the thing is with stuff like sexuality is it's learned. If you tell someone they're a lesbian as they're growing up and shit, they'll be lesbian. And it's just not right because you're taking advantage of that by being with them, you know?
The English version is just, scan me, yeah. But then the Scottish version is, scan your can. It's the Burger King.
Why is she in a wheelchair? This is weird, is anyone? Why is she standing up fine 1 minute and the next she's in a wheelchair? She's an ambulatory user as a result of chronic illness. The karaoke room, the room I was standing in, wasn't where wheelchair accessible, but the Burger King was. See, this is the thing though, it's not like she was just walking. She's literally picking this fucking unit of a human being up. You're strong, man. Does that really look like a wheelchair user on the right picking up a 200-pound hunk of a woman?
I never brush my hair, but I've got my great giraffe to do it for me.
Okay. My great giraffe. It's like she thinks it's like ownership. So weird. It's so fucking weird. Like, I think the reason why in the LGBT community it's easier to get like groomed and shit. That's a mad thing to say, but like, I think it's because people who are LGBT are just automatically seen as like not capable people of doing something like that. Like, they're seen just inherently positive, like good people, when actually some of them aren't. Some of them are terrible people and people just don't expect them to do shit like that. So you have this person commenting, this is so wholesome, and they clearly, I think, they're an official TikTok account for hidden disabilities. They're looking at it like, oh, this person has disabilities, this person's autistic, this person's trans, you know. They have all these, I don't want to say issues, but like, they have all these elements. It must mean they're a good person. It doesn't work that way. You know, it doesn't work that way. Like, what I'm saying is, like, a straight guy, you know, you can believe a straight guy's grooming pretty easily.
I appreciate it.
I love your sabotage club card.
Like, to the big sheep, slay.
It's clear this isn't just friendship. Like, it's more than that, and it's weird. It's so weird.
Wait, remember like the first time I sort of woke up and you like handed me the pillow, pillow.
They're holding hands! Oh
that
no!
Thank you, Abby.
Be careful.
Okay. Oh, thank you.
Yeah, I can help.
Aww.
There you go.
Oh, thank you.
Why are you fucking holding hands when you're 19? This is a 14-year-old girl. What the fuck is wrong with you? How is this allowed? Like, what? It's so weird.
I'm the best person ever in the world.
You are.
Rainbow slug. You're walking Marla and you're walking me.
Why do you need... Why do you need a wheelchair?
You are. Rainbow slug.
Why do you need a wheelchair to go to goddamn Asda where you can walk that bastard dog? Like, what? Bro, get the dog to tug the wheelchair. It's just so dumb. It makes no sense. What the fuck is this angle?
What are you trying to do? Oh, beads.
I don't want to sound like... disgusting, but you're literally filming her bending over. I get that she's in clothes and everything, but it's sexualized. And you can just tell it's more than just like friends. That's what I'm trying to get at. Bro, look, this is what she looked like 2 years ago. She literally looks 10. And that's it, really. I want to make it clear, like, with this video is made, like, it's serious in the sense that it's about serious topics, but I'm trying to make, like, jokes out of it as well, but I'm hoping that people still get the message of the video. Like, grooming is really bad. Like, I don't think people deep how much power you can have over someone when you talk to them from such a young age and when the power complex is so on one side. The thing is, I know people might be quick to go, oh, but, you know, you can have a relationship with someone if they're a child. You just make sure it's not sexual. That's not logical. Okay, it will just go to that point. Like, it will just get sexual. You can't just not do that with someone. It just doesn't really work that way. Like, there will be a time and a place for it. And if you do that, you know, you'll commit a crime. At the end of the day... You know, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I don't know how it turned out, but I'm going to be doing weekly uploads. So if this was a bad video, guys, don't worry. Next video, there'll be a great video coming out of the oven and you guys will be smiling at that one. Thank you guys for watching. Smash the like button if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to the channel if you're new today and I'll be seeing you guys later. Take care, guys. Woo.